put on a Pirate uniform and play baseball. It was like Christmas morning every day, I tell you. It was a great life. And I was so fortunate to have been able to play on some great teams and play here in Pittsburgh. And Bill is hell-bent, I'm going to tell you the story about Mickey Mantle in the 1964 World Series. And I am very, very proud to have been part of two teams that defeated the Mantle Maris Yankees in 60 and again in 64. I have a picture on my wall at home, which means a lot to me because Mickey and I were very good friends. And it happens to be a play that occurred in the 1964 World Series, absolutely the most perfect picture you could have. To start out with, we won the first game in St. Louis in 64. The Yankees won the second game. Now we go to Yankee Stadium. And Mantle and Maris were something to be feared about. Third game was a great game. So 1-1 tie in the ninth inning. And John Keane takes Curt Simmons out of the starter as a pitcher with two outs. Nobody on. Why? I don't know. But he did. And we're bringing a reliever. And Mickey was a dead high ball hitter, right-handed, and a dead low ball hitter, left-handed. Barney Schultz had done a great job for us in relief. He cranked up a knuckler. It didn't knuckle. It was right around his knee. He hit it so far, I couldn't believe it. So help me, the ball was still in the air, and I'm standing next to Ken Boyer at third base. And all of a sudden, I looked down at our right fielder, Mike Shannon, who's wacky as a bed bug anyway. And he had that little short fence at Yankee Stadium, and he's standing on like he's going to catch it. But both Kenny and I are sure this is a strange ballpark. Maybe it's not hit as far as we thought. Yes, it was. It was hitting the third deck. Now the game's over. We're down 2-1 in Yankee Stadium. The next day, Ray Sadecki starts for the Cardinals. The Yankees score 3 runs in the first inning. Nobody out. And men on first and second. The guy at second base happened to be Mickey Mantle, of which I have this great picture. As he was standing on second base, I said, Mickey, did you have any doubts about that ball going out yesterday? He said, oh, shit, Dick. He said, I got it all. I knew that was gone. I said, would you happen to check